Hello, and welcome to Big Screen TV, the online music show featuring some of the best local bands, artists, and venues. I'm Hal, and I am half as long as twice my length.
And I'm Sammy, and I'm using sign language today because I need to show off my skills in the hopes of getting a new job, because this is about to finish. Coming up on today's show, we have in-studio performances from Lovely Assistant.
And location performances from S.L. Walkinshaw and Ruth Patterson, filmed at the Star and Shadow Cinema. Sammy, are you signing everything I say?
Yeah.
Well, stop hanging around down there and come and join me. Hey, hello, mate. So, I can make you sign anything I want.
Yeah.
I am going to make you look like such an idiot. Time to taste your own medicine. Okay, here we go. I think Mrs. Brown's Boys is the best thing on television. Here's the first song from Lovely Assistant.
Outside, I know the roof lets in the rain. I wanna drive it all the same. The people that I meet, they have their future, and it'll change. And I'll be some of the way with you. I'll be some of the way. People that I meet, they have their future, and it will change. treat that mystery dearly. You never know when you might start to find a new forgiving heart. I gave your mother the lie, I didn't want to see her today. I wouldn't speak a word of a burden, but ever since you're gone, some of the way.
We're here with lovely assistant, and as it happens, me and Hal are looking for an assistant, but not just any assistant, a lovely one. So what we've decided to do is interview the band collectively as our lovely assistant. But that would be too easy, wouldn't it, Hal?
Yes. Sammy is going to interview you in BSL, and you're going to have to interpret the questions for your job interview. Sounds like fun. All the questions are sort of job interview related. That's the only clue we'll give you. And yes, as Sammy said, answer on behalf of the band. So Sammy, if you'd like to take it away.
Right.
If you get this.
I've got absolutely no idea. The beginning's a bit like, who the hell do you think you are? And then it goes a bit.
Well, that's you burning your hand with a flame.
Have you ever burnt your hand with a flame? It's not that.
It's not that.
It's not that, unfortunately.
I've got no idea.
I'll give you a clue. I think the answer to the question is no. Mm. But I might...
Would you care to venture a yes?
Yes.
Have you? When?
Yeah. It's usually the Grand Canyon.
Yeah, it is.
Have I ever been in a helicopter?
Yes!
Yes, the Grand Canyon was a good clue.
Yeah.
I haven't. I've never been in one.
I've had one.
Have you? Yeah.
Have you?
Broke my collarbone skiing and took us down in the helicopter. That's pretty good. About £1,000. £1,000 bill.
Yeah. You know you can get the for cheaper.
Oh, my God. That was it not traumatic? And I'm sure, assuming if you've broken your collarbone, you don't get a look out the windows.
All I saw was the roof of the helicopter. Yeah.
Was it incredibly loud?
It's all a bit of a blur.
As you say, does the morphine take the edge off that? Matt?
Yeah.
Are you
good at washing your hands?
Are you?
Yeah, very tough.
There was a lot of hand washing there.
Mm-hmm. I take hand washing
clean hands.
Very seriously.
Yeah.
Good, well, that's what we like that in an assistant. It was actually, obviously. Which do you prefer, cats or potatoes?
I'm going to go with potatoes.
Do the sign for potato.
Cat.
Do the sign for
potato.
Cat.
Yeah.
Very little in it. I mean, I can imagine all sorts of terrible instances. Have you baked the cat? Yeah. That's what you told me to do. Why is there a potato in the litter tray? Okay, Annie, next question. Are you ready?
I think so.
Big old clue there.
I was going to say something strong, but...
Ooh.
Think you're in a job interview. Yeah. What, might you be asked in a job interview?
How strong are you?
Well,
every job interview, historically.
If you need to rotate a chicken, that's the sort of thing that they're going to need to know.
Yeah.
You're close. Anyone else want to have a guess?
What are your strengths?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, of course it is.
How strong are you? Can you lift that up?
Yeah, collectively.
How strong are we collectively?
Yeah.
Oh,
how strong's the band?
So strong, yeah.
What band
the
could
strongest.
You knock out? From history.
What, physically? Or
In a fight. If you could fight any band, who are you fighting?
Take you in?
Some of those old vaudeville acts, probably.
Chaz and Dave, could you guys knock out Chaz and Dave?
I don't know. They've got an edge to them, haven't they?
Yeah. I would have thought Chaz and Dave probably.
I was thinking just some kind of jazz band.
Yeah, some folk, like with the real old folk, yeah.
Just practice being as relaxed as possible for years, and maybe we could just take
any solo artist we could not.
That's an unfair fight. But lovely to watch. In Amsterdam, there was a spate of people picking up smart cars and hoying them in canals. And apparently it only takes four reasonably strong people to pick up a smart car and hoy it in a canal. So there you go. You can take on a smart car. Yeah.
Get in.
Put that on your band's resume.
That's what we're doing tonight.
Forever there.
Right.
Like, how good are you at making a cup of tea?
Ooh, not bad. It not was bad. Tea or coffee.
Coffee.
Very close.
How good are you at making a cup of tea?
I know how to do it. Can't be bothered.
That's not the attitude we're looking for in an assistant, I've got to say. It's almost like you don't want this job.
I've never heard anyone say they can't be bothered to make a cup of tea. Yeah. I don't like hot drinks because of the devil's temperature, but just apathy.
Takes ages.
Well, that's lovely. We're going to deliberate. It's not an instant yes, but it's certainly not a no. And we'll get back to you. Thank you very much for the assistance.
Thank you very much.
So, can you teach me some sign language?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. I'd like to say I am really good at my job.
Okay. So, I really good.
I'm really good.
At my job.
At my job. That's brilliant. Thank you so much.
You're more than welcome. Here's the first of our location performances from the Star and Shadow Cinema. This is S.L. Walkinshaw.
Thank you.
And that's that.
Oh, this is so much fun. Right, how about I have a pretty face.
No, you don't. Here's the second song from Lovely Assistant.
You don't come here too often. You make my day when you come around. You know I love you something awful. You're a diamond I found. You make my day when you come around. You know I love you something awful. You're a diamond I have found. I wish I had not said that, baby. If I could only close you out. Sunset passes oh so sweetly. It gives a man just time to think. Frees your spirit and your body. Fantasy is on the blink. Wish I had not said that, baby. If I could only close you out of my taste you once again. Feel the pain and the pleasure. We can make it till the end. I wish I had not said that, baby. If I could only close you out of my mind.
So what's my name in sign language?
Well, you would normally just spell it. What happens is you get like a sign name over time.
Ah,
so your friends will pick a name for you that links to like characteristics about you.
Oh,
so mine is Sammy, because I'm happy.
No, you're not.
I am when I'm with friends.
Oh, right. So what would mine be?
I think you'd probably be Hal.
Hal? Ooh, Hal, I like that. What does that mean?
You really don't want to know. Now it's time for our second performance from the Star and Shadow Cinema. This is Ruth Patterson.
A dozen red roses laid on my front door. Looked around, nowhere, not a sound. And my heart hit the floor. And oh, I know it's all to please me. But the perfume stings my eyes. And not adjusting to the bright light. Fine wine and dining it. It sticks in my throat. You give me diamonds. Well, 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 it might as well be gold. You've missed the point, babe. love is always silent. I know just what I need now, and I'm gonna take my time.
Right, we're back once again like a couple of renegade masters, and we're here with lovely assistant, and we're going to be asking them a series of questions, as tradition dictates, that are either daft
or not daft.
So, Kieran, I think we shall start with you. Would you like to be asked a daft question or a not daft one?
Daft, please.
Oh, OK, this is a banned question. So I don't know how familiar you are with collective nouns for animals. For instance, owls, it's a parliament. There's a pandemonium of parrots, yep. And unkindness of ravens. What would be the collective noun for you lovely assistants?
A small greenhouse.
A small greenhouse? Would you fit
small,
in?
Not a greenhouse. A small greenhouse.
Oh, a small greenhouse?
Small greenhouse.
Oh. That's lovely.
But yeah. Covered in big balloons, like up.
Yeah. Next up, Annie, would you like head daft or not daft?
He will go with not daft.
Oh, will we? Okay. Create the ultimate supergroup from your favourite musicians.
Oh. Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, how big are we talking?
Just standard. Go for a four-piece. Replace yourselves as a supergroup.
Right, okay. Probably bigger than a solo artist.
Definitely would have Matty Healy from the 1975. got too excited about that then. Leanne Le Havis.
Well, that's a good one.
So those two would maybe be like the front guitar-y, singy duo. And then this is going to be really bad. Who else
Dave.
Do I know?
Bringing up the rear.
You know what? Well, yeah, we'll just Black go with eyes. That. Chaz and Dave.
That's quite the super push.
Okay, next up, daft or not daft?
I'll stick with the not daft.
Mm, okay. If you could be a fly on the wall, who would you listen in on or buzz around?
I'd probably want to buzz in on some Radiohead sessions and watch them fight and stuff.
Do you think they fight?
Do you know all the time.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Like,
well, they said, like, Hail the Thief was the album they don't like because they didn't fight at all.
Also, yeah. Do you think that tension?
I just like to watch them fight.
Do you ever fight as a band? Do you get on quite well? Or has there been any tense moments?
Passive aggressive.
Oh, yeah, I love passive aggressive.
Yeah, we'll build up to it, aren't
we? Do you think we should do another take of that? How was that for you?
Or can you hear yourself? Yeah. In the
can
cans, that's the one. Yeah.
Can you hear yourself?
Brilliant. Right, Dave, daft or not daft?
I'm going to go daft.
Okay, Dave, start a rumour about another band or musician.
So you want me to do local?
Oh, yeah.
This is dangerous. Stuart Walkinshaw eats people.
I've heard that.
Pass it on. Oh, God.
He does. He's like the army. He's the army hammer of the post-punk world.
I like how dark he went.
Yeah. Well, I didn't know how dark they went before, you know what I mean? I didn't want it to be a dip. I thought I'll have to go heavy.
And you've started some...
cannibalism.
Yeah, he eats people.
Yeah, he does.
That's a shame, isn't it?
I know.
With him being on this episode.
I know.
Oh, I'm not going to be able to look at him the same way. That's horrible to find out.
It is horrible. Yeah.
Do you know specifically which bits he likes?
He likes people from Bedlington.
It's very.
He says they've got a particular flavour, which.
Well, like the terrier.
Yeah.
They just taste like they've got that little pompadour. Delicious.
Thank you all very much for indulging our questions. You've been so much fun, and it's been great having you on the show. Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you. Thank you to lovely assistant, and we will let you know about that job.
And also thanks to SL Walkinshaw and Ruth Patterson for their performances from The Star and Shadow.
And if anyone really does need a BSL interpreter who's sort of, you know, clever and funny and very bendy...
I'm available! And I've got a lovely face.
Hmm. So to play us out with Stutter 4pm, here's lovely assistant.
Doesn't it hurt no more? Doesn't it hurt no more? I'm really glad to see you. I'm glad to know you're okay. Doesn't it feel like it did? Only passing through. To see you years ago, but I know you've nothing to answer. Well, I got nothing in my head at all. I can't see how a chance in the street could upset it. Doesn't it feel a little like it used to do? Not only passing through, I'm only glad if you're glad. Gonna let me buy a moment back. Doesn't it feel a little like it once did?